Yet at times, Mr. Sessions seemed committed to revealing as little information as possible, particularly about his interactions with the president. Pressed on his rationale, Mr. Sessions allowed that Mr. Trump had not invoked executive privilege concerning the testimony of his attorney general. "I am protecting the right of the president to assert it if he chooses," Mr. Sessions said. "I don't understand how you can have it both ways," said Senator Angus King of Maine, an independent who caucuses with Democrats. "You've testified that only the president can assert it. I just don't understand the legal basis for your refusal to answer." Mr. Sessions' appearance did little to move the White House beyond the shadow of Russia-tinged investigations, which have for months consumed the president and his team, often with firestorms of Mr. Trump's own making. On Tuesday, as the attorney general came to Capitol Hill, his administration was straining to play down suggestions that Mr. Trump is considering firing Robert S. Mueller III, the special counsel investigating possible ties between the president's associates and Russian officials. Mr. Sessions spoke from the same hearing room where James B. Comey, the former FBI director, testified last week that Mr. Trump had tried to derail an investigation into Michael T. Flynn, the president's former national security adviser. Mr. Comey, whom Mr. Trump fired last month, also accused the president of lying and defaming him and the FBI. That testimony colored much of Tuesday's hearing, with Democrats pressing Mr. Sessions on several key elements of Mr. Comey's account. Among the questions, why was Mr. Sessions involved in Mr. Comey's firing months after Mr. Sessions had removed himself from involvement in the investigations after failing to disclose past contacts with the Russian ambassador? "It is absurd, frankly," Mr. Sessions began, "to suggest that a recusal from a single specific investigation would render the Attorney General unable to manage the leadership of the various Department of Justice law enforcement components that conduct thousands of investigations." Mr. Sessions also addressed Mr. Comey's recollection of a private meeting in February with Mr. Trump when Mr. Comey said the president pressured him to drop the Flynn investigation. Mr. Trump asked to be left alone with Mr. Comey, the former director has said. Mr. Sessions stayed behind at first but then left, according to Mr. Comey.